Kia ora everyone, tēnā koutou katoa, nō mai haere mai ki te whare paramata. And of course, it's Maori Language Week. So I hope all of you are actually trying te reo and just giving a little bit more kōrero to te reo during this time. It's a good opportunity for us who aren't familiar with the language to try and embed it a little bit more in our everyday language. It's been a busy time for me. We had a recess week last week, but it certainly was no rest. I had Nick Smith, Minister for the Environment in Dunedin on Tuesday, where we launched the Love New Zealand Bin campaign. This is really important, particularly in the lead up to the arrival of over 85,000 visitors to New Zealand for the Rugby World Cup. There's a really good opportunity for us to make sure that as they are travelling around the country, they are given good opportunities not only to get rid of their rubbish, but also to recycle it in a proper manner. So more than 50 bins are going to be placed around Dunedin. That's more than Auckland are going to have, which I'm very proud of. And the bin launch was made last Tuesday. Tomorrow I've got Stephen Joyce, Minister of Transport, in town. That's tomorrow, Thursday the 7th, for another milestone, which is the opening of the State Highway 88 bypass around behind the Forsyth Bar Stadium. Now, this was a project that has been on the cards for quite some time because of the increasing traffic volumes from the city to Port Chalmers, increasing truck traffic going down Anzac Avenue. And with the construction of the Forsyth Bar Stadium, it made it more important that that bypass was built. It's completed now, and we'll be opening that tomorrow morning. Great opportunity for me to be back in the city that day, because in addition to that, the Rugby World Cup 2011 roadshow hits Dunedin, and so that'll be covered on Breakfast News tomorrow morning, so I'll be popping along to have a look at all of the exhibits and events. The cup will be there, of course, the trophy, and also some promotion for the Real New Zealand Festival, which starts to coincide with the Rugby World Cup. And it's hard to believe now that it's just 9 weeks till kickoff in Rugby World Cup 2011, and only 4 weeks till the Forsyth Bar Stadium opens, which is another very important infrastructure asset which the government has supported, together with, obviously, with the City Council and the Otago Regional Council. Foreign Minister and Rugby World Cup Minister Murray McKelly was down there last week. He had his first tour through it for about a year, and he was absolutely blown away by what a fantastic asset this city now has. So a couple of really big events in advance of that. And really, the other big news, of course, is planning for the campaign. It's not going to be long now before the Rugby World Cup passes, and we'll be heading into an election. So the choices for public are going to be really clear this year, I think, with Labor announcing, or sort of announcing, a capital gains tax. And as a chartered accountant, I know that the policy of capital gains tax is fraught with difficulty. Probably my colleagues, the tax accountants, will get more work out of it than the Crown will get revenue. But at least we're going to be campaigning on some very clear policy directions. So look, that's it for me. Busy time in the House, but we're working hard. Thanks very much.